Tokyo Station, and it's 7 a.m. It's now 11 o'clock, and all the heavy lifting is thankfully over. An hour later, we reach the supermarket. This is our second time here, though with the camping craze sweeping Japan, now we find a few tents rather too close for comfort. With the tent already pitched, for a change we begin a pannier-free ride. Now on the southwest shore, this park is another free campground. If we had our gear, we'd happily call it a day and camp here. Such lovely luxury.
Alright.
It's 6:55, and finally, the clam fishermen are out. Twenty clicks north, the whole world of difference. Welcome to the modern world, where the customers do the work and the staff are conspicuous by their absence. Now the climbing begins and the mist drifts in. As expected, the beach is a rubbish heap. And the final convenience store. Time to blow her so-called bear whistle. Cows laying on the grass, a supposed sign of rain to come. A place for a break, as well as my backup camp. And the adjacent abandoned school.
Have a little break here and
this monstrosity has shoveled down half the mountain to the right, too hideous to video. It seems to excrete cement powder, though hell only knows. And it's also the gatekeeper to this adjacent quasi-national park. Built in 1876, this later became the first electric lighthouse in Japan and is claimed to be the brightest. Near the end of World War II, the lens was destroyed by the American Navy. Even so, fishermen claimed to still see the light and follow it safely back home. There's a strong blustery wind, and after riding around the whole area, this turns out to be the only place offering shelter.
Thank you.
These horses are supposed to roam free around the lighthouse area. There were plenty of ups and downs, though now the real climbing begins. There's no video, but the super steep descent was truly death-defying.
Is it hot? Is it warm?
I found a way into the abandoned house, though it was too dusty to sleep in. These windmills are planted here by grieving parents. Yes, the Death Temple ticket includes this onsen. Unfortunately, the water is too hellishly hot for angelic me.
Lucky you.
Climb, and we're constantly attacked by flies that have an obsessive interest in our faces. Constant braking, going down is sometimes as hard as going up. And then you just fly like a bird. Supposed to camp around here, but first a quick 10-click ride to the coast for groceries.
Thank you.
back at the camping area. This is a surprise, though no obvious way in. And excavated tunnel. Pitch black with only Yuki's phone screen for light. This is perhaps the first time we use a pay campground. We can't find a good place for the tent and heavy rain is forecast. This shelter is ideal for comfortably killing time. The fellow with the big voice is a local, retired and hard of hearing. He spends much of the summer here. The hideous horrors of car camping. We camped under the shelter of those trees.
あの、あの、ね、去年の暮れに亡くなった人がいるから。